Have you ever wondered how to add music to your online conference or Skype call? Well, with ESI Audio Interfaces and DirectWIRE, you can do just that. And in this video, we will show you how to do it.
The DirectWIRE functionality of ESI Audio Interfaces like U22 XT makes it possible to play audio in one application and then transfer it to another one, completely inside your computer and without any external cables or mixers. So you can play whatever you like and send it to any streaming or video conferencing software. I will now show you how this works with Windows Media Player and Skype. Let's start by configuring Skype. Go to the Settings menu and into the Audio and Video section. I am selecting U22 Channel 1-2 as input device since I'm using a microphone connected to the U22 XT input. And for playback, I choose the U22 XT speaker device so that I can hear the sounds from the Skype call. Since I also want to play a song in the Windows Media Player, I need to change the default device in the Windows sound settings. I can reach that via the U22 XT control panel. Most audio players use the default playback device, which means that other playback software would work as well, even the browser with YouTube for instance. It is important to separate the audio from Media Player and from Skype, so I'm selecting a different playback device here. And I set Virtual Channel 3-4 as default. You might wonder why this is important. Since Skype is also playing the audio from others in the call, I do not want to send what they have to say back to Skype. It would not only annoy them, it would also generate a feedback loop. Now let's go back to the U22 XT panel to open the DirectWIRE dialog. There are different sections. Input represents the physical input signal from the audio interface, in this case the microphone I am using. The WDM MME column represents the playback and recording of standard Windows applications, and the ASIO column is for playback and recording of professional audio software that uses ASIO. Since I want to send the signal from Windows Media Player, which will be sent via channel 3 and 4 to Skype, and since Skype streams from input 1-2, I need to connect output 3 with input 1 for the left channel and output 4 with input 2 for the right channel. Both the Media Player and Skype are not using ASIO. Now everything for Media Player can be streamed by Skype. Since I also want that the other person can hear my voice, I need to connect the input channels to the WDM inputs as well. Finally, I enable Mix 3-4 to 1-2 to make sure that I am able to listen to both the other person and the music I will be playing. Now I'm ready with all the settings and I can go back to Skype and start the call. Hey Rebecca!
Hi Klaus!
You need to listen to this new cool song from Score Squad.
Okay. Oh, that's great.
Yep, I think it's awesome.
Yeah. I really like it. It's a cool song.
Yep.
We are always interested in what you do with ESI devices. So if you like, comment below this video and tell us about your project. And of course, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. See you next time.